All right, let's get into today's top stories now. And the New South Wales flood emergency continues, with some parts of the Hunter experiencing flood levels not seen in 70 years. There have been dozens of rescues. Dramatic footage shows police saving a 72-year-old woman from her car on a flooded causeway near Kempsey. And lifesavers helped ferry this 10-month-old baby boy to paramedics after he was found unconscious by his parents.
Prepare for the worst, and obviously the best happened, and Bub started crying, and that was fantastic to see that we knew that's a good noise to hear from a baby.
Also among those rescued is Eliza Hoyland. She had to be choppered out of her family's farm in Wollumbye after it was completely cut off. Eliza, good to see that you're alive and well tonight. I know you're 21. Your folks had left you at home to run the farm on your own. What happened next?
Well, Dad was heading back to Sydney on Sunday and the water was creeping its way across the road. So he turned around and quickly grabbed Mum so that they could head down to Sydney together. And I went to bed, everything was fine. And then, yeah, on Tuesday morning, we had metres of water over the driveway. So a bit scary, lots of water, a bit trapped after a little while.
Yeah, so had you actually decided to stay, or did you just actually wake up to find yourself stranded and in this pretty difficult predicament?
Well, when I woke up on the Monday, we only had that one access route covered. So I had the emergency exit, that we call it, to get out if I needed it. And then it wasn't until the following day, so yeah, that Tuesday, that I woke up and I was just absolutely stuck. And I had hundreds of missed calls from everyone around me, sort of freaking out because, no one really expected it to be as severe as it was. And like everyone is saying, it was just all of a sudden. And yeah, definitely did not choose to stay. Definitely got stuck, unfortunately.
Eliza, how did you save the cattle?
It's a bit of a story. So I woke up in the morning and I got the horses out, let them go up the mountain, and then, yeah, saw that the cattle were surrounded by water pretty much. So I waded across to them and it was only about knee-deep at that time, not very safe, but I knew that if I didn't get them then they would have, I don't know what would have happened. But yeah, they weren't coming. The current was flowing. It was really deep water and cattle aren't really known to like that sort of environment. So yeah, I thought I was only across there for maybe 5 minutes, but it was actually 45 minutes that I was trying to get them back across. And by the time I turned around, the water had risen by I don't even know how much, but I was crossing back over and it was almost up to my chin, I think.
Wow.
So I was pulling myself along the fence. Yeah,
were
I got back
scared,
in the car,
Eliza?
And drove
this
back
sounds
up to the house.
Were you terrified?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. I think I was just running on adrenaline. I think I still am. Really scary week. Absolutely, yeah.
Yeah, it's quite an adventure you had. What did your mum say when you finally got reunited with her today?
I think she was really happy. There was a few tears of happiness when we all got back together this afternoon. It was really nice. And they're just happy that I'm safe and the cattle are safe. Really happy ending.
Now, I know your family have had the property for only 2 years. How many times has it flooded in that time?
So we had the March floods last year and then again March floods this year and then this flood. So three already in the 2 years.
Will you stay,
Lots of
Eliza?
Water.
Will you stay?
Sorry?
Will you stay?
Will I stay?
Will your family
Absolutely.
Stay at the farm?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Well, it's good to see you safe and well and smiling and with your mum talking to you after all of that.
Thank
Eliza,
you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.